After 4 years of battling the city of San Antonio, the city manager and the police chief, Lieutenant Joe Savaggio, gets his promotion. It has been a long journey since Savaggio was fired after allegations he cheated during the captain's exam.
We asked the police department for an interview with him. That was declined. Also, we asked to be there today for the promotion ceremony. The coordinator for the public information office told us that we were not invited, and that was a decision he had made.
4 years after being fired from the department by Chief William McManus, founded allegations of attempting to take a posted note out of the captain's exam. Savaggio won an arbitration to get his job back. But that wasn't the end of it. The city of San Antonio and SAPD spent the next 4 years and taxpayer money to keep him from returning to SAPD.
In exactly 2 weeks, the city of Leon Valley will have a new police chief.
Captain Joseph Salvaggio has spent almost three decades with the San Antonio Police Department. Come September 15th, he'll go from working on a force of over 2,000 to commanding a force of only 30.
Let me ask you this. Why did you want the job here in Leon Valley?
I thought it'd be a great challenge. I think the department is a very good department. It's a good city.
Back in 2010, he was accused of cheating on the captain's exam.
You learn something from everything and every incident that goes on in your life. If you don't, you're not doing what's right.
All right, right here's good.
No, come on.
Why are you grabbing me?
It's okay.
It's not that. No, I'm fine. Don't grab me.
Okay.
So.
Nobody's grabbing you.
He grabbed me.
He touched you.
He grabbed me.
Okay.
First of all, why is there no filming allowed inside this lobby area?
This is a municipal court area. It's court areas.
Mm-hmm.
And the judges have requested there be no filming in the court areas.
Mm-hmm.
That's why. And the judges have that right to do that. It's been talked to with the Attorney General's office, and we've got it approved through the District Attorney's office. It's a court area. It's just like municipal court is downtown.
So you're not allowed to film inside those doors?
No, sir.
Are you familiar with Turner versus Driver?
Absolutely.
Absolutely?
Absolutely. And there's exceptions to that. And when court and court offices are an exception, it's in the penal code as well. And we will continue to enforce that.
As for his vision for Leon Valley, Salvaggio says it's a city with more minor crimes than violent ones, saying he plans to put a big focus on community outreach.
There's no court in there.
That's the court offices right there when you walk through that door, okay? So there's no need to argue about it. We're not going to discuss it any further. If you want to make your complaint, by all means, fill it out. We'll take your complaint, okay?
So we cannot film in this lobby because it was approved by your district attorney and the attorney general? Is that correct? Because I'll go ahead and I'll write this down.
Go ahead right now.
Okay?
Go ahead right now.
And then I'll follow this up with the attorney general. Well, first I'll do your city attorney first.
Go ahead right
and then the attorney general.
Go ahead right now.
Okay.
You said you're going to write it down. You got your answer twice, three times probably.
No, I'm just going to see if you're going to retract your statement. And by the way, I wanted to give you this. Would you like to take it? Because I'm actually the Turner and Turner vs. Driver, by the way.
Okay. Cool. I appreciate that.
Can I get a copy of that signed and dated from the records office?
Right now?
Before I leave?
No, you can't.
I can't?
There's nobody in there. You can't. So you'll get your record. We'll send it to you. Is there a place that you want to send?
I would just like a receipt saying that I submitted that.
You've got it on video?
No. I would like a paper copy.
Well, you're not going to get a receipt saying you submitted it.
Well, can I get a copy of that?
No, you cannot.
Why not?
You have it right here for your viewers to see. There we go. Everybody see that? You submitting that?
Okay. Is there a problem with me getting a paper copy?
Yes. You're going to pay for it?
How much is it?
It's at least 15 cents.
That's not an issue.
Okay. Just give me the 15 cents and I'll go get your paper copy.
You got change for a 20?
Nope.
I would like my paper copy.
Okay. Well,
are you refusing to accept my money for a paper copy? Because that's
you
what I'm asking for.
Well, I'm telling you I don't have change. If you want to give me the 20, I'll go work on getting change. It might be a few minutes, though. A
few minutes?
I don't know how long.
Yeah, sure. And for the complaint process, initially I just wanted to see what the process was, but since he grabbed me, this is what I'm complaining about.
Okay.
Are you okay? You okay, sir? Your hands are a little shaky.
Huh? Did you need EMS because he grabbed you?
No, are you okay because your hands are shaky?
Come on.
Why are you grabbing me?
It's okay.
It's not that. No, I'm fine. Don't grab me.
Okay. For a lot of people get in trouble when y'all are doing this, just when y'all come to the places and we're asking y'all to leave and y'all don't, then it's becomes a problem.
It's extremely important for the community and the officers to work together.
That's not the way to fight it.
Right.
Hey, Mr. Turner, there's your receipt. There's your copies. Wait a minute. She missed her copy.
Oh, before you go back in there, I didn't want to make us like a trip.
Okay, Mr. Turner, there's your copies. There's your receipt. Here's your money.
All Perfect. Right.
You have a great day.
One second. I didn't want to have you make a second trip. I was wanting to get a copy of that order that you were mentioning, or the ruling.
There's no written copy for it.
There's no written copy, so it's all verbal.
So no written copy for it.
All right, but if it's just, it should be an open record, right?
There's no written copy for it.
So how do I go about getting a document of this?
If there's no written copy, that means there's no document to give.
But if this is something that you guys are enforcing, there has to be some sort of ruling or a document stating that this is what this is and it's been approved by the Attorney General with the stamp.
It says that where?
No, I'm asking you because you're saying that this was passed down by the Attorney General and the District Attorney.
You just made a statement that there has to be a written ruling for us to enforce it. I don't know of any law that says that we have to have a written ruling to enforce the law. It's already in place.
Okay? It's already in place.
Law's already in place.
Can I open records that law? Because I might not know it.
It's in the Penal Code and the Code of Criminal Procedures. Judge has a right to restrict municipal court and municipal court areas.
So, just to reiterate, I can't.
Let me go get your copy.
I can't video record it, right? I can take pictures, right?
No photography, no video, no nothing.
Nothing?
Yeah, actually, cell phones aren't even allowed in here. But no problem.
But once again, there's no sign, just saying.
Now, Salvaggio also says he plans to implement some new community programs once he takes the reins.
Flash after flash after flash. 10 red light cameras are recording every single violation.
The city's red light cameras went live nearly a month ago.
Hello, everybody. This is Chief Salvaggio from Leon Valley Police Department here in Great Leon Valley, Texas. I'd like to talk to everybody about some problems that occur quite frequently, but even more frequently during the holidays, and that's thefts and burglaries of vehicles and of homes. But even more frequently during the holidays, and that's thefts and burglaries of vehicles and of homes.
So what that means is that you can have your property seized by the government without being charged with, let alone convicted of any crime. The burden of proof is flipped on its head. This American presumption of innocent until proven guilty is changed in civil forfeiture cases. If your property is targeted for forfeiture, you have to prove your own innocence to get it back.
And burglaries of vehicles and of homes. There's some simple things that you can do to keep these criminals from coming out and taking your hard-earned items.
You don't need to be proven guilty of a crime for your goods to be taken away.
Please search warrants.
Cars, homes, cash, all assets the government can seize.
We in America should not be losing our property without being convicted of a crime. And that's exactly what civil forfeiture allows.
Civil forfeiture is happening in towns and cities across the country, and it is perfectly legal.
There's some limitations on it. You know, it's actually not really on the forfeiture.
There's some simple things that you can do to keep these criminals from coming out and taking your hard-earned items. There are simple things that makes that person go to just the next person that might not have done the simple things that I'm asking you to do today. While you're shopping, and probably the biggest issues we have during the holidays, people go shopping, they throw all those beautiful bags with those great presents inside the vehicles, and the thieves come along, they just walk down the aisle, look inside the vehicles, and they'll break in the vehicles and steal your items.
Ready to grab it.
That's your driver's license.
What crime have I been suspected of committing?
What's that?
What crime have I been suspected
you
of committing?
You have no brake lights.
Is that a crime, officer?
It is.
Oh my God!
Never leave those items invisible in a vehicle, put them in the trunk, but don't go out to your vehicle and put it in the trunk and then go back in the store. Everybody knows that any of your vehicles these days have a trunk release. So if you're gonna put them in the trunk, you put them in the trunk and drive off, or at least drive to another area where they might not see where you're going. Otherwise, you just bought some items for a thief, and it happens constantly, not just here in Leon Valley, but it happens everywhere. Same goes for keeping items out of your vehicle when you're at home. These guys walk down the street and they just try the door handles, looking in vehicles, try the door handles till they find one that's open. Even a pair of sunglasses, $150-$200 is a inviting thing for them to steal. So keep your items out of view, keep your vehicles locked, and take your keys. You wouldn't believe how many vehicles are stolen every day. In reality, there's one vehicle stolen every hour and one vehicle burglarized every 20 minutes. Not just necessarily in Leon Valley, but in this area of Texas. Also, you know, it's kind of interesting when I see these items go up in people's yards, really expensive items sitting out there, and, you know, packages being left and those types of things. It's pretty amazing to think that during the year, we wouldn't leave a $250, $300 projector just sitting in our yard. But during Christmas time, we buy these things to make our houses look pretty, and the thieves go around and steal them and sell them on the black market for a very cheap price.
My fire chief jokingly said it looked like a disco show.
Flash after flash after flash. 10 red light cameras are recording every single violation. Starting Wednesday, February 21st, running a red will cost you $75.
If you're going to put a projector in your yard, don't leave it out at night. And stake it to the ground where somebody just can't pick it up and run with it. Better yet, chain it to a tree so they can't steal it at all. Or buy items that only you can stake to the ground so that people can't just run off with them. Thieves during this time don't have the same Christmas cheer. They go and steal anything and everything that they can.
We're doing a servant eviction on you. You have to get changed clothes, stuff like that, and take off in about 15 minutes.
The young couple and their son have only the time it takes a locksmith to change the locks, 10, maybe 15 minutes, to grab what they can.
Right now you have to leave the premises immediately.
He carried out 15 the day we met him.
It's hard.
Today, we'll probably end up doing probably about 25 to 30.
In one day?
In one day.
The constables of Las Vegas are on track to carry out 40,000 evictions this year, 6,000 more than last.
So please do not leave items in your front yard. And if you do want to put those things out, please stake them to the ground or make it very hard for people to steal them. And your homes. During Christmas time, everybody loves to put their Christmas tree in the window with all the beautiful packages there so that everybody can see how prosperous we've been in the last year. Not a great idea for everybody to be advertising what you have in your home. The thieves see that, they come back and they break into the house, and your hard-earned gifts now become their easily earned gifts that they're giving to their families and friends.
We can give law enforcement an incentive to use forfeiture if we set up a special fund in the Justice Department and the Treasury Department where all the forfeited monies would be deposited and then earmarked just for law enforcement purposes.
We had no idea that it would over-incentivize law enforcement in the long run.
I think it boils down to three words: policing for profit.
We're entitled not to be deprived of our property without due process of law. And nobody cares. Nobody cares.
You can watch it on TV every night. Something along those things are happening. Not so much in Leon Valley. We're pretty blessed. We want to keep it out of Leon Valley so that you guys don't have to be impacted by these criminals. So please keep your blinds drawn or keep your presence out of sight so people can't see them. If you're going to leave for the holidays, please make sure that you leave lights on, leave a TV on, leave a radio on so that it gives the appearance that somebody's at home. You should do that always when you're gone, but especially during the holidays. And if you're going to be gone, have your mail stopped, have your paper stopped, and have a neighbor or friend watch over your house. You can even contact the Leon Valley Police Department, and we will patrol by your house during the time that you're gone. So it's a free service that we provide. We definitely want to make sure that your items that you have worked so hard for are not stolen, and we want to make sure that everything there is safe and cozy when you get back home.
Does this happen a lot?
All the time.
So please don't hesitate to reach out to us, contact us, and let us know what you have going. And I ask you one last thing. If you see something, anything that's suspicious, please reach out to us, let us know.
You and your friend got any money by these thrill show tickets? Support your police department. $10 each, man. Either you buy these or I take your car.
I'm in New Jersey law with the alarming and all that. I don't fall under alarm because I'm in a public building recording, which is my first and second.
You know, by the way, people don't even care about that because Obama has decimated the freaking Constitution. So I don't give a damn because if he doesn't follow the Constitution, we don't have to.
It's New Jersey case law.
Yes, you don't have. Did you get that?
$10 a piece.
All right. Pay there.
No. You already paid. You got these tickets, man. Go support your police department.
Okay.
Support cops like me that instead of taking your shit, you two walking.
Mm-hmm. I have
spot Easter's tickets.
All right. That's it. Cool.
All right. You got $30, $10 a piece.
$30? I get two? I don't want to take this guy.
Well, let him buy it too, or else I'll take the shit.
I'm going to do it this $5.
He assaulted me with less than probably 3 minutes of being in there. I got assaulted by that little guy. I don't know his name. I need your name and badge number, sir.
I will be with you in just a minute, sir.
I need your name and badge number. Sir, I need your name.
Whoa.
Hey! I need your name and badge number.
You stand across the street right now.
Okay. I need your name and badge number.
Right across the street.
This is a public sidewalk, guys.
You can get tased, guys.
It's a public sidewalk. I didn't do nothing.
Don't you resist, buddy.
I didn't do nothing.
Don't you resist.
Don't you resist.
You will get tased.
I didn't do nothing, guys. You're not resisting, buddy. You're not resisting.
Police department, reporting you pick up.
I'm hearing about that report from an accident we had.
Okay, what you got to pick up?
One phone call could solve a lot of problems for your neighbors, for you.
All right, kids, pull up a chair. We're calling Leon Valley.
Hi, Suzanne. I wanted to report gang activity.
Okay. Do you have the address or cross streets?
Yeah, it was right inside the police lobby of the Leon Valley Police Department.
Okay. Were these like known gang offenders or?
Yes, repeated. With a long history.
Okay. Do you know the name of the gang that they're affiliated with?
I think it's Bexar County Sheriff's Department, but it's Leon Valley Police Department, including the chief.
Okay, so that's gonna be a separate phone number. I can give you the number for the Leon Valley.
Okay, great. Thanks so much.
Bye-bye.
And for this entire community, if you see something, please say something. Happy holidays, Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah to everybody in Leon Valley and the rest of the world if you see this. Thank you.
Rules about not filming courthouses to also protect the police. We've seen the same thing here in Crowley, Texas. So obviously two people in the community got kidnapped and abused physically, severely. There was blood on the sidewalk. So the community has responded by drawing attention to it. We're gonna be out there peacefully, safely, protesting the vast abuses of power that we see all around us. The violence, the coercive power of the state, any and all of the above. Ruled on by judges, enabled by lawyers, and enforced by cops, sheriffs, bailiffs, etc. And this is going to be a response to show that, no, you can't just beat people up that want to have cameras in public spaces. If you don't want a camera in your cop shop, it's because you have something to hide. This chief of police needs to go.
We still don't have our property back. Let me give you an update on what happened yesterday, though. Let me turn the camera around here. So, my vehicle was released to my wife yesterday. My wife had to drive down here with two kids and the baby, 4.5 hours, so that they would release the vehicle to her. We got down here, she got down here a little after 4 o'clock. They released the vehicle to her. They charged her $295. They charged her $295 to give the stolen vehicle back for a false arrest. No charges. Not only that, but there was no reason to impound the vehicle. The vehicle had nothing to do with even, didn't even have anything to do with the alleged charges. Nothing to do with it. But they went and they stole it anyways. And that's why I say stole. I know some people are saying, oh, well, quit saying stole. It was an impoundment. Quit saying kidnapped. It was an arrest. You know, guys, this is what actually happened. There wasn't even charges, guys. Therefore, it was a kidnapping. It was theft. It was Grand Theft Auto. So anyways, they released the vehicle for her. They charged her $295. And when we got back in the vehicle, the pistol that was in the vehicle is missing. It is not in there. When I was in the cell, when they had me in the police department here, one of the officers came in and said, hey, is that your gun in the car? And you know, got this attitude of like, why do you have a gun? Why is there a gun in the car? Because this is America, goddammit. That's why there's a gun in the car. You better believe there's a gun in the car. Ask me if it's mine. I told them I don't answer questions. So I know that they knew the gun was in the vehicle. And it's not in there anymore. So Leon Valley is guilty of gun confiscation. Confiscating guns from law-abiding citizens. Confiscating guns at all is gun confiscation. Leon Valley is guilty of gun confiscation now for the second time. Jack Miller was the first time that I know of. But in this whole deal, that's the second time they're guilty of gun confiscation. So we got the vehicle back, but lost $295 for it. They stole a firearm. I'm pretty sure that's a felony. I don't know. And like I said, I know that some people are saying, oh, don't say stole. No, they took it for safekeeping. No, that's not, no, no. There's no charges, there's no crime, there's no reason. If I came and took your gun, that's not okay. That's theft. So that's the update on what's going on with my property. As far as phones, cameras, all of that stuff, they still have over 20 devices from all of the individuals who were out here that day. From phones to GoPros to cameras, all kinds of equipment. Ethics instead had his phone taken from him, and you can see it at the very end of my live stream, the 3-minute live stream where everybody gets arrested and phones confiscated. You can see them take Ethics instead's phone, all right? They lost it.
He didn't get a property receipt because they don't know where his phone is. He's come back in multiple times and said, hey, can I get a property receipt for my phone? And they said, we don't have your phone. They lost his phone. When we were in the back, there were two people that were detained, including a pissed off veteran, I believe. But when we were in the back, they were losing phones while we were back there. They had everything totally disorganized. They didn't know what was what and whose was whose. And if you see the way that they came in and just started attacking everybody, throwing stuff and stealing property, you can understand why they have no idea what's where. They've told him multiple times, we don't have your device. Everything is accounted for and you don't have a device. We didn't take your phone. It's on video, guys. Guys, we need the property back. We need it all back. What's going on here is wrong.
Congratulations. You are being rescued. Please do not resist.